I would like to mention here that some or full content of this session may help you to be a cyber aware, being a cyber savvy, and help you to understand the security concepts while preparing for any cybersecurity exams like CISM, CISA, CISSP, etc. CISM, you can find this in domain 4, which is Information Security Incident Management, and CISSP, you can find under Security Operations. Cybersecurity professionals must deal with a wide variety of threats as they plan and implement security controls. Conducting a threat analysis is an effective way to gauge the cybersecurity risk facing an organization. During a threat analysis, the cybersecurity team uses professional expertise in the threat intelligence and other information sources to develop a comprehensive list of threats facing the organization. Once they have developed a list of threats, then they evaluate these threats based on two criteria. First, they assess the likelihood of each threat. This likelihood judgment incorporates the team opinion about how likely is that the threat will materialize and how likely it is that the threat will actually target their organization. This likelihood rating may vary significantly from organization to organization for same threat. For example, consider the threat of an attack by a foreign government. The likelihood of this threat may be very high for a defense contractor to maintain the sensitive military information, but much lower for a restaurant chain that doesn't have any information of interest to that foreign government. The second evaluation factor is the impact of the threat if it could materialize. When we evaluate the impact of threat, we take a number of factors into account.
So the second evaluation factor is the impact of a threat if it should materialize. When we evaluate the impact of a threat, we take a number of factors into account. For example, we assess how much damage the threat could cause us. If we are looking at threat of a hacking attack, we might judge the ability of those hackers to obtain and use sophisticated tools that are capable of bypassing our layers of security defense. Once we have these threat information compiled, we can create a threat register that lists all of the threats that we have identified and their likelihood and impact rating. The register is very crucial when conducting security assessment and deciding whether to make investment in new security controls. As you conduct your threat identification and classification exercise, it's helpful to keep a classification matrix known as a Johari window. The Johari window classifies information into categories based upon whether it is known to us and whether it's known to others. This window has four quadrants. In the context of cybersecurity threat, there are known knowns. These are threats that we know about, and our adversaries know about as well. Published vulnerabilities, virus, we know signature, and brute force password attack all fit into this category of known known. Then there are known unknown. These are threats that are known to us but not known to others. For example, we might have discovered a security vulnerability in our infrastructure that's not detectable from the outside and that attacker are not yet aware of. The category of unknown knowns contain threats that are known to others but not to us. For example, if an attacker discovers a new zero-day security exploit but has not yet used it, they know of a security threat, but we have no way of knowing about the threat until the exploit is actually used or it's discovered independently by a third party. Finally, there are unknown unknowns. These are security threats that nobody has discovered yet. Every vulnerability that is discovered by researcher fit into this category before the time it's actually discovered. There are many vulnerability out there that fit into this category. There are security threats that we haven't yet discovered, but they are silently waiting to reach the light of the day.